In this video, you will learn to create pie charts from summary data using StatCrunch. The data set I am using is called Categorical, Variable, and Summary Form. This is just a toy data set that contains two columns of data. The var1 column contains unique observations of a categorical variable, and the counts column contains the number of times each associated value in the var1 column was observed. So in this case, the value of B was observed 4 times, and the value of A was observed 6 times. Let's begin by creating a pie chart. To do so, under the Graph menu, choose Pie Chart with Summary. In the Categories In box, I'll choose the var1 column. In the Counts In box, I'll choose Counts. Click Compute. The resulting pie chart is shown with a legend displaying the values associated with each color, as well as the count and percentage of each value. So for example, the value of A is shown in blue, the count is 6, and it represents 60% of the data. StatCrunch allows the user to display the count and/or the percent in the legend of their pie chart. I would like to display only percent. So under the Options menu, I'll choose Edit. This takes us back to the original window where we built our pie chart. In this window, StatCrunch has other options for the user to customize their pie chart. In the Display box, I'm going to deselect Count. To do that, I'll hold down Command on a Mac or Control on a PC. Now only percent of total is highlighted. I'll click Compute. And now only percent is displayed in the legend. Notice by default, StatCrunch displays the values in ascending order, or in this case, alphabetical order, so that A is at the top of the pie chart. Also by default, StatCrunch draws the first slice of the pie chart at 0 degrees in trigonometric terms, or at 3 o'clock. We can change both of these defaults back under the Options menu. In the Order By box, it is set to default to value ascending. Value descending will reverse this order. Count ascending and count descending will order the pie chart by the frequency of the values rather than the values themselves. For this example, I'll choose value descending. You will also notice the Start Angle box. It defaults to 0. I'll change it to 90 degrees. This will start our pie chart at 90 degrees in trigonometric terms or at 12 o'clock. I'll click Compute. And now you can see the value of B comes before the value of A, and it begins at 12 o'clock. StatCrunch also provides the option to combine values with a small relative frequency into an other category. Back under Options, you'll notice a box labeled Other if percent less than. For this example, I'll enter 50. This will group all values less than 50% into one other category. I'll click Compute, and as you can see, the B values are now labeled as Other. Also, you will notice that StatCrunch has changed the order of the values in the pie chart. The Other category will never begin at the starting angle. As you can see, this is really not a great idea for this data set, but it shows how StatCrunch can create this category if it is needed.